Now let's see about rotational partition function. As we have seen in earlier classes, rotational degree of freedom is different for linear and non-linear molecules. In case of atoms, there is no rotational partition function. We have seen that in case of atoms, we have translational partition function, and in molecules, we have translational, rotational as well as vibrational partition function. For linear, the degree of freedom is 2, and for non-linear, the degree of freedom is 3. Now let's see how we can write the rotational partition function. As we have written for the translation, in the same way we will write 0 to infinity. Here it will be gr. I term has been dropped here for convenience. E to the power minus er upon kt, where gr is the statistical weight factor for rotational energy level, er is the rotational energy level. These are the two quantities we require for calculating the partition function. So let us see, the statistical weight factor for rotational energy level is given by 2j plus 1. That means the degeneracy of rotational energy level depends upon j, the rotational quantum number. For example, if j is equal to 0, then the degeneracy will be 2 into 0 plus 1. If j is equal to 1, the degeneracy will be 2 into 1, 3. Okay, sorry, 2 into 1, 2 plus 1, and accordingly the degeneracy will be 3. Okay, so you see that we can find the degeneracy of the rotational energy level just by using the formula 2j plus 1. Now let's see what is the rotational energy level. You all have studied in spectroscopy as well as in quantum mechanics the expression for rotational energy level. In quantum mechanics, we have seen that when we solve Schrodinger wave equation for rigid rotor, in which we consider diatomic molecule as a rigid rotor, we get the expression Er is equal to j plus 1 h square upon 8 pi square r. Like this is the equation number 1, 2, 3. These are the main equations which we will be substituting. Here I, you are all familiar with this, moment of inertia. I is moment of inertia, which is given by mu r square, where mu is reduced mass and is given by m1 into m2 divided by m1 plus m2. So using this, you can calculate the moment of inertia, and substituting the value, you can get the value of Er. Here, R is bond length. J is the main term, that is rotational quantum number, and it has value 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. So this is the expression for degeneracy and energy for rotational energy. We will substitute this in this equation, and we will get QR is equal to summation 0 to infinity GR is 2J plus 1 e to the power, this is J plus 1 h square upon 8 pi square I, and we are having this k theta. So this is equation number 4. Now, as we have seen in translational, this term x square upon 8 pi square I is small in comparison to the thermal energy kT. So the rotational energy levels, though they are far from translational energy, but they are still we can consider them as closely spaced. You have seen the different values of J. The gap goes on increasing. J is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. But still we can consider them as closely spaced. So this summation will again be replaced by integration sign. So QR is equal to integration 0 to infinity 2J plus 1 e to the power minus J plus 1 h square upon a pi square I kt, and here the integration is with respect to J, so we write dj. Here again we have these as constant for a given molecule, so this will be h square upon 8 pi square I kt. We can replace it by a single constant, let's say beta. This equation 5, this equation 6. We will substitute for this beta. So what we will get here is, we get beta dj. Let this be equation number 7. Now, for simplifying this, we will do some simplification here. Let us substitute for J plus 1. For this, let us substitute a single term, that is Z. On differentiation of this equation, we can get the relation between dz and dj. So if we differentiate this, we will get dz. This is dz with respect to dj we are doing. This is j square, so we have 2j. This is j, differentiation of j with respect to dj will be. So we have equation number 8 and equation number 9. So we will substitute this in equation 7. We will get QR is equal to integration 0 to infinity 2j plus 1 dj. Okay, for this we will write dz, and for j plus 1 we will write z. So we have e to the power minus z beta dz. And for this type of integral, the standard integration gives 1 by beta. So let this be equation number 10. So what will be the value of QR? QR will be simply the inverse of this beta. That means this will be 8 pi square I kt upon h square. For all the linear molecules, whether it is diatomic or polyatomic, this equation will apply, where I is moment of inertia, K Boltzmann constant, T temperature, and H is Planck's constant. This equation is valid only for, in case of diatomic molecule, if you see, it is valid only for heteroatomic molecules like HCl, NO, etc. In case of homoatomic, only half of this will be thermally accessible. That means for homoatomic, this equation becomes 8 pi square I kt. Only half of this will be thermally accessible. So we have, so in heteroatomic this value is 1 and this is 2 here. So in general form we can write, we can introduce a term known as symmetry number. So we can write QR for whether it is heteroatomic or 8 pi square I kt upon sigma h square, where sigma is known as symmetry number. And this is symmetry number is nothing but suppose we are having the homoatomic molecule, you can take N2, O2, etc. Suppose we are having N2 molecule and we are rotating this molecule along this axis. When we rotate it through 180 degree, then we get an orientation which is indistinguishable or same as that of the original one. So while rotating through 360 degree, we get two such indistinguishable orientation which you have learned in group theory. So here the symmetry number is nothing but it is number of indistinguishable orientations which we get on rotating through 360 degree. So for polyatomic the expression will be little different, for spherical, asymmetric and symmetric top depending upon the moment of inertia. We will see it and its numerical in this lecture.